groundwater. Again, the broad picture of groundwater with very little dots being picked up. मैं इसलिए बताऊं क्योंकि इस शहर में 4 लाख बोरवेल है, इस शहर में 4 लाख बोरवेल है, pumping out 400 to 500 million liters per day. The net investment by individuals for this 4 lakh borewells is 8,000 crores, which is more than the state's investment for all the water utility that it has ever put in, into place. So if you look at it, total investment in water for extraction and supply is coming from the so-called private sector or the individual sector. That's the state of affairs. Whereas the imagination of the city is that it's the state utility which is providing you the water. And therefore, it is in the interest of all these 4 lakh borewell owners that there be groundwater, rahe aquifer mein, that it be as high as possible, and that it be as of the best quality as possible. Because their investment, capital investment, will only fetch a return if this condition exists. How do you make sure that they then act to keep their capital assets fresh? That's the challenge. That's the broader challenge. But as a state subject, if you look at it nationally, institutional responses have been different. Like Maharashtra has, for example, the GSDA. No other state has the equivalent of a GSDA. Yahan, the Groundwater Survey and Development Agency, GSDA. Maharashtra mein hai, institution whose sole job is to look at groundwater in the state. No other state has it, the equivalent. Yahan pe Karnataka mein, mines and geology mein, water is considered a mineral, and it's with the mines and geology department. So institutional responses are different. Therefore, if you have a state, if you have a countrywide law, how would it imprint itself on the states would be a big question as things go along. But we have a history. Ye kuwe ko koi pehchanta hai? Kahan se hai? This is Lothal, close by, Indus Valley Civilization. Lothal. So the history of it is circa 2600 BC. That's when our wells are coming from as a groundwater civilization. Mohenjo-Daro. Individual wells, but also community wells. Dholavira, open wells, individual wells, community wells. Lothal, same. If you look at any one of this, Kalibangan, any one of the Indus Saraswati Valley civilizations, the notion of the well was both private and community. It was there. And this is the sort of historical connect. Sarnath, the Buddha, near Banaras. No tank, no river nearby. Pani peena hai, to kuwe se peena hai. Are we connected to Gautam Siddharth, not only through his teachings, but through the well from which he drank water and we are privileged to drink water because this well has water and the water is sweet? Connects. When we talk sustainable technologies, do we talk about, can we think of a technology which has served from Buddha's time to now and is still relevant? But we are fast making it irrelevant. No, sustainability, historical connects, tradition, culture, aquifer, we are a groundwater civilization as we go along, right? One will see. Ye to dekha hoga hamare correspondents ne IWP, HWP wale. Dekhe honge na koi? Kaam karte dekha hai? Kon dekha hai? Haath to utha hai? Haan, teen hai. Teen haath uthe. Aur kitne uthe hai? Kaafi uthe hai. Arre baah, bahut, bahut achi baat. Bahut achi baat. Ye, this is 1300 to 1400 years old as a technology. The well liberates mankind from the tyranny of rivers and lakes. When you discover that a hole in the ground can provide you water, you are no longer to be near the river or the lake or the pond within 12 hours. Now you can go anywhere. Dig a hole in the ground, there's water, you can survive. This is the first liberating or destructive incident for mankind. Then develops the science or knowledge, codified knowledge. Where do you dig? How deep do you dig? You start reading the science of the land. Trees, bushes, termite mounds, soil, rock types. And then you pass it on as codified knowledge. Dowsing. You know? Nariyal leke ghumte hain, wife fork leke ghumte hain, pendulum leke ghumte hain, pani nikalte hain, dhoondte hain, hai na? Dekhe hain. Do you know how groundwater is identified? Pata hai na, ab borewell ka point khojna hai, to kaise khoja jata hai? अभी बोरवेल का पॉइंट खोजा जाता है चिकू तो कैसे खोजा जाता है सो हियर वी हैव दिस दैट यू स्टिल यू मे गेट अ जियोलॉजिस्ट एंड देन यू डबल वेरीफाई विद द डिवाइनर एंड यू बिलीव दैट द डिवाइनर वर्क्स बेटर देन द हाइड्रोजियोलॉजिस्ट दे स्वेयर बाय द डिवाइनर एंड दे डोंट ट्रस्ट द हाइड्रोजियोलॉजिस्ट सो इट्स गॉट टू सच अ स्टेट दैट हाइड्रोजियोलॉजिस्ट गो अराउंड कैरिंग पेंडुलम्स एंड कोकोनट्स इन दिस कंट्री ऑफ आवर्स बिकॉज इफ यू हैव टू रन अ बिजनेस एंड अर्न अ लिविंग दैट्स व्हाट यू हैव टू डू सो द हाइड्रोजियोलॉजिस्ट गिव्स यू अ पॉइंट नॉर्थ ईस्ट में दे देता है बिकॉज दैट ऑल्सो सेटिस्फाइज वास्तु There are many constraints in the Indian complex. Apart from sub-aquifers and participatory groundwater management, you have to comply to Vastu, you have to comply to the coconut falling from your palm. And then you drill for water. And this is, let me tell you, this is humorous, but this is the way it is, the science of this subject as it is developing in this country. Because we've moved from it for becoming a visible resource to it becoming an invisible resource. And if you have 25 million borewells or 30 million borewells, and if you have to now send in a modem or a camera to 450 feet below the borewell to find out how water comes, and the imagination is that of a pond or a reservoir or streams or lakes, whereas actually it is cracks and fissures in the ground which bring water into this small 4.5-inch or 6-inch opening in basalt or granite or gneiss, then I think your imagination of the use of water would also change. But 25 million farmers ko kon samjhaye ki kaise hai pani wahan pe, aur samjhane ki zarurat hai kya aur batana kaise hai, unless it has to be participatory. Can you do it through legislation? That is the question. Ye sawal aap uthte hain, jaise this is the fissure from which water is coming into a borewell here. There will be one or two or three fissures. This is what you would call 1-inch water, 2-inch water, or 3-inch water, which you would extract using 30 HP, 50 HP pumps, provided generally free by the government as electricity. So let's see how the World Bank sees this. We have to understand and validate a lot of things that come from various sources, right? And this is worth a read. If you have not read it, this paper called Deep Well and Prudence Towards Pragmatic Action to Address Groundwater Depletion in India, it's a World Bank publication. So it flags the fact what Tushar Shah has been talking for a long time, that we are the largest users of groundwater in the world, 230 cubic kilometers. More than a quarter of the global total, 25% of the global groundwater use is in India, 60% of irrigated agriculture, some say 65%, and 85% of drinking water. This is our groundwater dependency. But kahani shuru hui Lothal se, Dholavira se, Mohenjo Daro se, aur yahan pahunchi hai. Aur pura pani jo hai, wo antarjal wala pani hai. Wohi pani hai. Aur hum wahan pe bhi number one the, abhi bhi number one. Then, so how do you manage this? So let me flag two words. Participation, the way it is seen by some. This is an opinion and a definition by me. Informed action in self-interest, not altruism. Informed action in self-interest, not altruism. And community is a group of users, or group of beneficiaries, or group in a common geographical area. But this is the way it goes. So this is a lot of reading. Yeah. So to flag one point, international experience in groundwater management presents few models applicable to the unique Indian setting. Flag that. Solutions have to be Indian, have to come from this setting. Bharat ka problem hai, to yahan se hi aayega hal, samasya ka. And what is more interesting, the intervention suggested by the World Bank is in three categories. Community-based groundwater resource management, World Bank says. Community-based groundwater management. Targeted regulation, it says it cannot be an overarching regulation, it has to be targeted and held. And sectoral policy interventions and coordination, which primarily comes from the power sector, which is the imagination of the World Bank. But even the World Bank accepts that with this number of borewells, unless you involve the community, and unless it's participatory, and unless it's knowledge-driven, there is no way that we are going to find a sustainable solution. Targeted regulation is that it is specific to specific aquifers. So regulations in the Indo-Gangetic plain will be radically different from regulations in the hard rock area, for example. That mapping is what is following. So there are two ways of mapping it. One is what the Central Groundwater Board is doing, which is doing a sub-aquifer mapping on its own, right? So that's the World Bank view. But you have to get down to the granularity of understanding your sub-aquifer. That also the World Bank swears by. How it is to be done, it's different. The World Bank also says that community has to be involved, participation has to be there, each user has to have the knowledge of what he or she is using. All that is also stated by the World Bank in this particular paper. And again, the World Bank goes to say, essentially based on the APFMAGS program, Andhra Pradesh Farmer Managed Groundwater Systems, or sir, that the available models of community groundwater management would need careful and innovative piloting. We need to pilot more such things before they can be replicated and scaled interventions happen. So we need more of participative community-based groundwater management system solutions being tried out across hydrogeological settings. We need a lot more piloting than what we have now, and we must understand a lot more about community, how communities will manage water, how regulations can target those communities, and how specific they are. The nature of scaling up also gets transformed. It's a million mutinies instead of one big million scale mutiny. Because the World Bank says it's an individual action in self-interest. And so the community is the community of users. And in within the community, if you tell each user how or what a borewell and an aquifer is and how it's linked to rainfall, then he or she makes an individual decision how to use the water. It need not be in a community setting. That is not the World Bank imagination of community participation. In the particular case of APML, GS, right? So that's their definition. Others define it differently. So how did the Planning Commission see it, the 12th plan document, right? With Himanshu there. And this is the draft model bill. And this is also on the web, worth seeing. But then here is a big articulation and a very nice articulation of the intrinsic CPR nature, common pool resource nature of groundwater, that it having to fulfill human rights first, and that it has to have ecological needs, it has to be linked to river flows, and it cannot be divorced from each one of these through segregating it as groundwater. It has to be seen as a continuum. That is the overall thrust. And therefore it makes all these points. And very interestingly, the unit of operationalization of by the state is seen as the Article 243G and 243W, which is the local self government. The Gram Panchayat or the Nagarpalika, they will be the custodians of groundwater who will act under a certain set of principles for managing groundwater and regulating it and ensuring its sustainable use. This is the document. It's a groundwater protection zones have been identified and so on and so forth, right? I mean, the gist of it all is, this is all available on the web. I'm just trying to point out that the direction of looking is different from different institutions, right? So the World Bank sees it in a particular way. Though it says community, it says participation, it says knowledge, it sees it in a particular way. The Planning Commission document, which is the model draft bill, sees it in a particular way. The model draft bill, by the way, has not become an act. And who will implement? It is local self-government. And how does the state actually see it? And I'm just picking one example of Karnataka state, which already has an act and has drafted rules and regulations. Karnataka ne kar diya pehle, wo draft dekhne ke pehle. Now, it goes about the typical bureaucratic way, sets up a groundwater authority, mans it with minor irrigation department, water resource department, mines and geology, falana tikana, all departments, secretaries constitute this authority. The whole business of it is through a process of licensing and approval. Before you drill a borewell, come to me, get a license and an approval. Pay 50 rupees if you have to drill a domestic borewell, 500 rupees if you have to drill a commercial borewell for commercial exploitation. I will then see whether this is in a safe zone or an unsafe zone and give you approval. And I'll also compare if it's within 150 meters of a public water borewell, and I will say yes or no. And if you give me a bribe, perhaps I will exempt you from all of it. So there's no clear objective to that regulation. The objective in itself is, the licensing in itself becomes the objective. The regulation becomes the objective. For what purpose, for what outcome is not defined at all.